Good afternoon, Digital Pinoys Worldwide. This is your anchor, Charlie Diaz, welcoming everyone to our new All Pinoy Alternative Music Program, where we support, highlight, and feature upcoming Pinoy artists and musicians. We believe that Pinoy music adoption and creativity must be supported at grassroots level to ensure its sustainability in the future. And that is why Napalm provides its digital platform so that artists, communities, partners, and listeners can collaborate and thereby enriching the Filipino music altogether. My co-anchor, a musician, a performer, a lyricist, a guitarist, and of course, a passionate alternative music advocate, Mr. Pards Moro.
Hi. Hi, Charlie. Magandang hapon sa listeners natin sa VT1, sa Napalm, specifically sa Napalm, all Pinoy alternative music. So, magandang hapon, Charlie.
Okay. Oh. Welcome back again, Pards. So, when we talk about the Napalm, no? Based from our past three episodes, we got some good reviews. Actually, we got some good feedback that we're featuring, you know, the bands, you know, upcoming and stuff, which is our main major ano naman natin advocate. But also, I think it's good that we are getting also some informations out there. Like yung feature natin before in the first episode, yung DWXB, that's a known fact that very few people know, but from the alternative music scene, that was really like the 80s. So I think ngayon you have to yes. You will be presenting a new portion of our program, which is called What the Fact or WTF.
We actually have a new segment, no? WTF or What the Fact. Okay, hindi ito yung mura, okay? Fact as an FACT, no? So What the Fact. Okay. The purpose of this is this is the segment where we get to talk about artists, bands.
So I think there's a little bit of problem there, no? But Pards is mentioning is actually yung all these influences on alternative music and even mainstream. Sometimes big artists, the mainstream artists that people are not aware of have Filipino or Filipino artists influences on them. So that's what we are trying to present in the portion What the Fact. So if Pards is here, he would have probably explained this, but for the time being I will do it. So this is the band The Pixies, and as you can see, there are four. This is a four-member band, which is during the 80s, going to the late 80s. It's an alternative. It's an alternative band based in Boston, Massachusetts. What is interesting with this band is this is a band that is like it's one of those that are sandwiched between, you know, the 1970s and 80s, the new wave era, and the upcoming 1990s, the grunge music. Before actually the grunge music, there were already acknowledgement that the Pixies are the ones that has the you know, started this whole music sounding characteristics of the grunge, while they are now, you know, producing their own compositions. Key interesting, you know, fact is that the style of the Pixies is what they call quiet loud. So there are series of intensity from quiet to loud music within a song. So parang it's not the usual chorus. Like, of course, yung chorus, it will come out as a, you know, pinaka kumbasa sa music, it's a punchline of the music. But this one has the volume of the song and the beat or the intensity goes up and down because of those compositions of the Pixies. So yeah. Arts, you can also tell us more about this grunge music.
Yes,
influence.
Okay, thank you, Charlie. Yung konsepto ng Quiet Loud is simple lang naman. Kumbaga, you can have your verse being sung quietly, no? And then when you get to the chorus, pwedeng may distortion kasabay ng medyo sumisigaw na vocals. So medyo exponential. So hindi naman siya bagong konsepto, no? Kasi ginagamit din siya sa mga kanta dati. Yun nga lang, subtle lang. For example, yung verse natin is medyo hindi ganun kalakas, ano? Pero may slight increase in volume, slight increase in intensity. Ina-apply na yun sa mga lumang kanta. Pero dito kasi, kaya tinawag na quiet loud, exponential yung difference niya between verse and chorus. So for example, naglagay ako dyan, like Smells Like Teen Spirit ng Nirvana, and ano niya, yung intro. And then, pupunta siya sa verse, biglang tatahimik na halos, hindi naman bumubulong, pero kumbaga, subtle lang yung pagkanta ni Kurt Cobain. And then, once you get to the chorus, medyo sumisigaw na siya, tas, together with the distorted guitars and yung amplified drums. So, ganun yung dynamics ng Quiet Loud. So, before it was used by Nirvana and any other bands na grunge sa Seattle, ginagamit na ito ng Pixies, mid to late 80s. So, before even nabanggit or na coin yung term na grunge music, ginagawa na ito ng Pixies, ano? So yun yung ano niya, yun yung isa sa mga pinaka ano niya. So it could be vice versa, pwedeng verse ang mahina, chorus ang malakas, or yung chorus naman ang mahina, verse naman yung malakas, ano? So two examples of those are yung Smells Like Teen Spirit ng Nirvana, Where Is My Mind ng The Pixies, and halos lahat ng grunge na maririnig mo may ganitong klaseng dynamics sa kanta. Isa pang magandang nangyari sa Pixies, it could be due to the dynamics, it could be due to yung nagustuhan ng crowd, ano? Even yung mainstream were hooked, tapos mayroon kayong minsan na naririnig na kanta, malaki yung chance na yung isa sa mga soundtrack na naririnig nyo sa mga pelikulang napapanood nyo ay galing sa Pixies. Nung ito yung ilan sa mga pelikula na nakita ko na Pixies yung ginamit nilang soundtrack. Okay, sa Fight Club, merong isang kanta sila noong 1999, Where Is My Mind. So, ginamit nila yon. In year 2000, meron isang kanta pa sa movie na Unbreakable, I've Been Tired. Daddy's Home, noong 2015, Here Comes Your Man. And yung 2019, last year lang, Godzilla, King of Monsters, Wave of Mutilation yung kanta na ginamit ng The Pixies. And if you try to check now sa IMDb or sa internet, yung list na ito could go as far as maybe siguro 30 or more na movies, TV shows, cartoons na ginagamit yung kanta ng mga Pixies. Ngayon, hindi ko alam kung ilan pa, no? Pero wala akong ibang banda na alam na ganun ka frequent yung paggamit nung kanta, except for this one, no? The Pixies. So aside from that, isa pang fact about The Pixies is, so hindi ko i-mention lahat, pero ito yung mga ilan sa mga sikat na banda na nag-influence or kumbaga napabilib ng The Pixies. So we have Radiohead. If you don't know Radiohead, if you know the song Creep, sila yung nagpasikat noon. David Bowie, isa sa mga pinakasikat na new wave artist ng 80s. Another band is U2. So ito din, isa sa mga bumilib or napabilib ng bandang Pixies. And syempre, yung pinaka malaking banda nung grunge era nung Nirvana, no? So yung Pixies, kung mapapansin nyo, these artists are karamihan dito is sikat sa Europe. Yung Pixies became more popular in the UK than the US, kung saan sila nanggaling, no? So try to imagine if the Pixies didn't exist. So hindi natin alam kung yung Radiohead ba or yung Nirvana ba ay magiging ganun ba ka-significant yung sound nila, or magiging ganun ba kaganda yung sound nila kung hindi na-introduce yung bandang Pixies, ano? Ito yung hindi alam ng karamihan, ano. So the Pixies has 4 band members. Yung isa doon, yung gitarista nila, si Joey Santiago, no? So Joey Santiago is the guitarist of the multi-awarded, world-renowned band The Pixies, no? Meron siyang Filipino blood. Yun yung hindi alam ng karamihan. So actually hindi ko alam na Filipino siya. But then nung nakita ko yung facial features niya, so sabi ko, this could be Filipino or this could be Mexican. And then nung sinerch ko, lumabas Filipino-American siya. So medyo nagulat din ako kasi Joey Santiago has not been, I think, interviewed in any Filipino based na program. But kung titingnan niyo yung mga nabanggit nating influence ng The Pixies, specifically yung pagigitara ni Joey Santiago, kumbaga napakalaki nung contribution niya, no? So the guitarist of the band that influenced some of the biggest bands in the world like Radiohead or Nirvana is part Filipino. So that's something to be proud about, no? So yun yung isa sa mga fun fact about the Pixies.
Okay.
So yeah.
So I think that's the what I think one yun yung ano, one of the most important fact about what we, you know, what our portion of this part of our program, what the fact is yes. we will dispense about the knowledge, no, yung mga informations about it, pero there was always a link back to Pinoy music or Pinoy artists, or you know, sabihin na natin half and half, feel American or feel British or so on, pero meron pa ring Filipino component as far as music influence is concerned. Well, actually we have so yung ano, just to ano, to before we go to for our break, this ano, this segment, we will of course play our game.
Yes.
Ang game namin is just like our last week, we have a game called Napalm Trivia. Etong Napalm Trivia namin, we will pop in 3 questions in the entire length of our program. So based on the 3 questions over the 3 breaks of 3 different segments of our show, we will feature each questions out there until by the end of the show, kung sino yung viewers natin na makahula ng tamang answer sa all 3 questions will win, of course, 100 peso game for 100 peso mobile reload. So whether it's a smart reload or globe reload, but it's really a mobile reload. So hindi, so we are giving it to 2 winners. So yung hindi na siya magagalit sa atin, yung isa na, oh, dapat na una ako, hindi yung pangalawa. Ngayon, 2 winners will actually vie for, you know, for, has a chance of getting that, ano, that winning answers for all 3 questions. Ayun. So before we end this segment, Dean, can you show us the first question of our trivia? And I would like to do a shout out to some of our viewers who posted the live comments in our Facebook. Jeffrey, yes. Flores, Mert Santos, Christine Magius Gaufo, Neil Canlas, Joan Jing Abalona, Coach Manansala, and then Denny Dunham. So we have a lot of you know, good, yes, viewers out there. Thank you very much.
Oh, karamihan dito, Charlie, is my mates from St. Joseph's College. So hi sa ating mga So nakikinig sila ngayon. So some of them are here in the Philippines, yung iba na sa US. So
yeah. Okay. So that's good. At least meron kang ano, you know, within your network, within your community. That's what we are trying to drive at here in this program, yes, Yung mga communities natin who are interested, who have the same wavelength as far as appreciation for Filipino music and this time alternative Filipino music, yes, then you know, we have a lot of things in common.
So our guest band for today is called Becoming Tatiana. So I met this guy from a common friend. Medyo kakaiba to from our guests before, no? So this current band is instrumental, so walang lyrics. So, pero syempre, we have to think that music is a sort of self-expression. So some of the musicians prefer lyrics or music with words. This band, ang gusto naman nila medyo instrumental. So lahat ng feelings, lahat ng mga iniisip nila, lahat ng mga influences nila, they put it together in one music form. So maraming ano siya, maraming fusion ng iba't ibang genres.
Hi, Pards.
Hi, Jay. Hi, Jay.
So, good afternoon.
Welcome to Napalm. Yes, kamusta?
Nice one. Nice one, bro.
Okay. So, si Jay is siya yung parang pinaka band leader or pinaka paano ba? Yung pinaka source ng music ng Becoming Tatiana, no? So, Jay, si Popoy ba is makakasama sa atin or medyo hindi makasama?
He's not feeling well, man.
For the band members, they have two actually band members, you know. So si Jay is actually the guitarist and the bassist, no? And then meron pang isang band member si Popoy Uy, he's the guitarist. So later on, malalaman natin kung bakit dalawa lang sila, no? So sige. First, Jay, could you tell me something about the band name, Becoming Tatiana? What's the story behind that?
Okay, Becoming Tatiana. So I just came from a band, you know, my other band, say a group metal band. So, syempre, medyo masculine, medyo angry yung tugtugan. So when I started this project, I wanted to flip the coin, ika nga. I wanted the other side of me. So I said, you know, I was tapping to my other side. So that is why Becoming Tatiana. So parang tinatap ko yung feminine side ko. Not in a gay way or LGBTQ way, but, you know, parang, di ba lahat naman tayo, lahat tayo mga lalaki, we have this feminine side and yung mga babae naman, meron din masculine side. So basically, tinatap ko yung feminine side ko para yung creativity ko hindi masyadong pumanig dun sa metal or something. I wanted something different, ika nga. So, yan. Kaya binaksakan ko yan. Becoming Tatiana. Yeah.
Okay. Para sa mga viewers natin, no? Si Jay kasi used to belong to a band named Sibilyan. Itong Sibilyan ay medyo hardcore, medyo mabigat na metal, you know, no? If you try to imagine, pag nagigig sila, ito yung mga gig na medyo mash pit, ganyan, sigawan ng sigawan, mabigat na gitara, maingay na drums. So yun. So what you're saying, Jay, is Becoming Tatiana is parang you can't be metal all the time, no? So there are times na kahit tayo, nanonood din tayo ng K-drama, nanonood din tayo, nakikinig din tayo ng mga Lisa Loeb, Bossa Nova.
I wanted na, kasi nga, dahil nga doon sa Sibilyan, na-tag ako na metal bassist ako or metal guitarist ako na I have so many influences na sabi ko, okay, gusto ko yung flip side. Gusto ko parang pakita sa kanila na, oh, hindi lang ako metal, parang gano'n. I'm a little bit diverse naman in my musical endeavors.
Tama. Alam ko meron din ganitong ibang artist sino ba to? Si Corey Taylor. Dalawa yung banda niya, right? Corey Taylor is Slipknot. May isa pa siyang banda na medyo subtle or medyo Stone Sour. Yun, Stone Sour. So, same artist, pero ibang music approach. Yung isa medyo masculine, yung iba medyo mainstream, kumbaga, ng konti.
Actually, ang parang pinagkunan ko is Tool. Si Maynard James
Keenan. Yes. Oh,
Tool. Sa Tool, medyo heavy. Paglipat nga sa Perfect Circle, medyo, di ba?
Perfect Circle, yes.
Diba, medyo like, so basically, ganun yung ano ko, yung idea. Yes. Just wanted to tap the other side of me.
So, itong Becoming Tatiana, how did you start as a band? Kasi dalawa lang kayo paano nag-start tong Becoming Tatiana?
So, yung Sibilyan, it's going into its hiatus at the time. So, parang this project started as parang solo ko lang parang solo project. I wanted to to learn how to mix and master things, to produce my own music, ganyan-ganyan. So ginawa ko siyang template na doon ako mag-aaral habang nag-aantay ako doon sa mga ibang members ng civilian. Then, biglang nakakagawa na ako ng songs, ganyan-ganyan. So, hey, Poy, I have this project. Are you interested? Tapos, ang unang sagot sa akin ni Poy, he declined, no? Medyo heartbroken ako nun. Dineclined ako ni Poy. Then, after 2 weeks, biglang nag-text siya sa akin. Sabi niya, hey, Jay, may guitarist ka na ba? Sabi ko, wala. Ikaw lang naisip kong guitarist dito eh. So, yun. Hanggang sa dun, nag-progress na siya. Eto na siya.
Yes. Okay. So, technically, yung sa Becoming Tatiana, who writes the lyrics or yung riff or yung melody? Sino? Sa ano ba kayo? Oh,
halos sa akin. Sa ngayon, sa akin, halos nagsisimula lahat eh. So, sa akin magsisimula yung drum patterns, yung sometimes missing, then yung pinaka-bassline. Minsan lalagyan ko nun na rhythm guitars. Then, other times, may mga songs naman na alam ko na sa isip ko na si Poy lang yung makakapaglagay nung particular guitar part na yan. Kasi when we do these songs, we don't rehearse or we don't talk about it. Basta on the spot yan.
Yung sa Becoming Tatiana, yung influence niyo, sino ba yung mga naging influence niyo musically?
Si Poy kasi is more on blues. Bluesero si Poy eh. Blues player, talagang true blood blues player yan. So ako naman, medyo funk, medyo alternative grunge, mga ganyan. So yan.
Yung blues na ano ba to? Referring to yung old blues or yung medyo bago-bago na? Like John Mayer, ganyan. Or B.B. King, ganun.
Yeah.
Yeah, yung blues niya.
Tapos hindi yung ano, hindi yung pop blues ah, yung talagang blues talaga. Yeah.
Yung kumbaga ano tawag dito, Black American based.
Yeah. The blues with the soul, man.
Yes. So you also mentioned about yung funk influence mo. Sino ba tong mga banda na kapag-influence sa'yo?
Chili Peppers, si Flea. Then, medyo atras ako ng konti. Napunta ako sa Chic. Then, sila Bootsy Collins. Then, medyo umatras pa ako. Napunta pa ako sa Motown. Then, sila James Jamerson, sila Carol K, Bobby Vega. Yan. Kasi naano ko siya from Stone Temple Pilots, si Robert DeLeo. So, I was into yung style ni Robert DeLeo. Nalaman ko, ang influence niya, si James Jamerson. Atras ako ngayon. So, na-discover ko si James Jamerson in the 60s. Then, yun na, sila Carol Kay. Then, yun na, Bobby Vega. Yun.
Ayun, anong medyo nagtataka ako dun, ano? Kasi si Stone Temple Pilots, medyo hindi lumabas yung funk influence niya doon sa Stone Temple Pilots doon sa mga sikat nila na kanta.
Yeah, pero pakinggan mo maigi yung mga gulong ng bass ni Robert DeLeo. Pag masisingle out mo yung bass lines niya, nandoon yung ano eh, nandoon yung Motown, nandoon yung groove.
Influence.
So sa akin, it's definitely like Korn, Killswitch Engage.
Okay.
Yung mga ganun, Killswitch Engage, Animals as Leaders, Periphery, Sting, Limp Bizkit, Nirvana, Alice in Chains.
Ito yung mga ano groove groove based na mga metal, yung mga new metal era. So around music, metal music around 2000s or late 90s.
Late 90s. Yan. Panahon natin yun.
Late 90s. Actually, yung pa rin naman yung metal ngayon eh. Yung, when you listen to yung millennial metal or yung metal na ginagana ng mga content din. Yun nga lang, medyo may ibang mix sila eh. Like, for example, there are bands now that incorporating yung groove metal together with R&B.
Yes.
Bands like
okay, yeah. So anyway, I think some of our ano, marami na tayong nakikitang comments, no? Mga shout out na I guess from some of our alternative music communities. I think marami na rin tayong nasabi about the influences, a little bit of information about becoming Tatiana. So let's go to the portion wherein we play the actual music of the Tatiana para marinig naman ng mga audience natin how the band is and how what kind of music that they're playing. So their first song is called Adrift.